It was 11:55 in the morning on April 23rd. They removed the ventilator from his throat, and they told me to, you know, kind of prepare yourself to gather around with my family and, you know, be prepared possibly for the worst. And we wept. The staff, they wept, and I wept too.
My name is Pam Jacobpack. I had COVID-19.
Pam felt pretty good the first few days. His coughing got a little bit worse. His temperature went up and down. But by a few days into it, he was definitely feeling weaker and coughing a lot more. So we agreed he needed to go get tested.
And then after I got it tested and the result came out positive.
When I realized Pam was positive for COVID, I was really, of course, frightened for him. I don't think I realistically thought he would get as sick as he did. That period of time when I can't be with him and not knowing exactly what's going to happen, knowing he has COVID, knowing he's being intubated but not being able to be there, it was extremely frightening. And they called me from inside the emergency room and told me how sick he was and that he would immediately be taken to the ICU, and he was immediately intubated and put on a ventilator there. So I went from a husband that told me he wasn't sick enough to go to the hospital to a husband that maybe had a 50% chance of living just in, you know, a day. So it was pretty scary. The concern then really became in the third week then. So we went through 2 weeks, Easter came and went, and they were still not able to bring him up. When they would try to lower his sedation and bring him back up to the surface, if you will, he didn't do well. Once we got those two negative tests, he really was able to turn the corner. They were able to get a CAT scan on his lungs. They saw all this fluid that had been squeezing his lungs, and they were able to insert a drain in a kind of a surgical procedure, and they drained out about a liter and a half of fluid that had just been surrounding his lungs that whole time, I'm sure building up and making it very difficult for him to do better. They had already reduced his sedation, and they said, all right, we're gonna see how this goes for 40 minutes. And when he made it through these steps, she came in and said they were gonna take him off the ventilator. Over the loudspeaker of the hospital, when you survive and get off the ventilators, they play a song, and they played Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles for Pam.
So when I saw her again, I wasn't quite sure what I'm doing here. I couldn't talk. My body couldn't function. I couldn't move, either my arms, my legs. I'm so glad to see her, but I couldn't understand what really happening to me.
If this were a movie, he would have said, oh, darling, I've missed you so much. Thank you for being by my side. But you didn't then really want to overwhelm him with the story. It was just a little too much for him to take in at first.
I couldn't even turn over. It would take one or two people to help me even to sit up. I tried really hard to convince Lynnette to sneak me out and put me in the car so I can go home.
This is one thing about COVID. It doesn't just impact your lungs. It can impact your heart in some way, your kidneys. And I think my advice to somebody who didn't have a medical background would simply be ask lots of questions. Know that laboratory tests are being ordered every day and they're guiding almost everything that's happening to a COVID patient. And simply just ask, what testing are you doing on my loved one? And what is the purpose of that test? What are you going to learn from that? And when you get the results, what are you going to do about it?
Well, before you come up with a solution, you got to know what the problem is. The lab professional is the one who identified the problems. Do I feel that the lab saved my life? No question. I'm not here today without her, and how much I appreciate what she has done and how lucky I am in my life, you know, being with her.
I tell people I just can't imagine a Lynnette without a Pam or a Pam without a Lynnette. We've grown up together, and certainly we're growing old together, and very thankful that he made it through.